Oh, hello. You know, I've been thinking completely of my own free will that Phyrexia isn't all that bad. Now, you may be asking yourselves, is the professor just saying this because a terrifying Phyrexian portal mysteriously opened in his office? Oh, Poopy. No, Phyrexians are great, and I welcome them. Why, the right Phyrexian artifact can be used as a spicy combo enabler in every commander color combination. And I'd like to go over each and every two-color combo with you to prove my loyalty to you. But first, the enabler itself. Making a return in Ultimate Masters, a previously $60 Commander staple, reprinted at rare, it's Phyrexian Altar. And I think that we should all bow down before it now. The reason I'm bowing is just because of its busted power level, and no other influence whatsoever. An artifact that for a mere 3 mana of any color, Phyrexian Altar allows you to sacrifice a creature to add 1 mana of any color to your mana pool. Put it in literally any deck for combo shenanigans. And I'd like to present you with 10 great Phyrexian Altar combinations, courtesy of myself and famed commander brewer Bennie Smith. Shortly after the portal opened, Bennie and I coincidentally sat down, bowed down if you will, to the altar of Phyrexian and came up with these magnificent uses for it. But remember, the altar is no good without something on it with which to sacrifice. So always have a chump or a thrall or an adjunct handy. Did I do bad? Never mind Nicol Bolas, the Phyrexian invasion of Ravnica has begun. The first line of defense, of course, is the Boros Legion, which also means they're the first to fall, and combining Phyrexian Altar with a Darkar Valkyrie and Thornbite Staff makes for a spicy combo. Tap a Darkar Valkyrie to make target creature that dies this turn come back to the battlefield under your control. This is particularly sweet when you bring back creatures with Enter the Battlefield effects like Sun Titan. Of course, now you've got to get it to die, and Phyrexian Altar to the rescue. Sacrifice it to Altar for any color of mana, and Valkyrie's ability will bring it back to the battlefield. Get ready to go arbitrarily large by equipping the Valkyrie with Thornbite Staff, which gives equipped creature the ability to untap whenever a creature dies. So now you can generate unlimited mana, and depending on your sacrifice target, unlimited enter or leaves the battlefield effects. One example for a little added Boros spice besides Sun Titan would be Archangel Avacyn. Phyrexian Altar lets you sacrifice any non-angel creature to transform her into Avacyn the Purifier, which will do 3 points of damage to each other creature and each opponent. Next, the Selesnya Conclave is going to make a great combo with Phyrexian Altar, using Melira, Silvok Outcast, and Woodfall Primus. You see, the big bad Woodfall Primus destroys a target non-creature permanent when it enters the battlefield, and Phyrexian Altar helps you cast it a turn or two early if you happen to have some expendable creatures about. Primus has Persist, though, which says if it dies and doesn't have a -1/-1 counter on it, bring it back to the battlefield with a -1/-1 counter on it. Oh, but Melira, Silvok Outcast stops your creatures from getting -1/-1 counters, so sacrifice Primus to Phyrexian Altar for, of course, lots of mana and mass non-creature destruction. Just remember that Woodfall Primus's ability isn't a May, so stop the engine once you've destroyed everything that needs to go. For a little added spice, Uvenwald Mysteries gives you a clue token each time one of your non-token creature dies. So the engine will give you pretty much all the clues you want, and then you can use all that mana to cash in clues for extra cards. Not to to mention that Uvenwald Mysteries also gives you 1-1 white soldier tokens whenever you sacrifice a clue token. And Selesnya loves those 1-1 white tokens. Next is Tesa, Orzhov Scion herself of the Orzhov Syndicate, comboing with Darkest Hour. Now, I've talked about this in my Tesa Commander deck tech, but Phyrexian Altar can be used to combo with Tesa, Orzhov Scion. Tesa's ability reads, whenever another black creature you control dies, create a 1-1 white spirit creature token with flying. If we cast Darkest Hour, all creatures are black, meaning that we can sacrifice any creature of ours, and Tesa will create a 1-1 flying white spirit that's black thanks to Darkest Hour. So sacrifice a creature to Phyrexian Altar with Tesa and Darkest Hour in play for infinite spirit tokens coming in and out and infinite mana. With infinite mana, there's a lot of fun ways to win, but for Tesa and your Orzhov flavor, why not a little Debt to the Deathless? I think that seems to be a great pick, and each opponent will lose 2x X life with this card, or just have a Blood Artist chilling on the field. So whenever one of these spirits dies, how does a spirit die? Isn't a spirit already dead? Oh, never mind. Target player loses 1 life and you gain 1 life, winning you the game. Come with me into the depths of House Dimir now as we descend the Tombstone Stairwell and combo this with Mnemonic Betrayal. Look, Dimir loves to mill people, even in Commander. Dimir loves to mill everybody, including yourself. So once you've dumped sufficient creatures into your graveyard, slam down Old School Enchant World Tombstone Stairwell. During each player's upkeep, each player creates a 2-2 black zombie tomb spawn for each creature in that player's graveyard. But at the end of each player's turn, all tokens are destroyed. This will give you a bunch of free blockers each turn that you can sacrifice to Phyrexian Altar to make mana. Once you get back to your turn, cast Mnemonic Betrayal, which lets you cast any spells from your opponent's graveyards. Sacrifice your temporary zombie tokens to the altar to generate the mana you need to cast a bunch of spells. And hey, for added spice, why not cast Nexus of Fate and other blue time walk effects to take another turn and do it again? But I feel that we're just playing around up until now. Let's do some serious business with the Is It League as we combo Altar with Locust God and Whirlpool Drake. The Locust God is popular both as a commander or just as one of the 99 in an Is It deck, and with good reason. When it is in play, whenever you draw a card, you create a 1-1 insect with flying and haste. And for 2 in a red and a blue, you get to loot, drawing a card and then discarding a card. So when we cast a card like Whirlpool Drake, a 2-2 for 3 and a blue, that when it comes into play, you shuffle the cards from your hand into your library, then draw that many cards, well, Locust God will create an insect for each card you draw. You can swing in with those insects since they have haste, then sacrifice them to Phyrexian Altar for mana to use with Locust God to draw more cards, create more insects, and even sacrifice Whirlpool Drake itself to Altar, as when it leaves play, you get the effect again. Shuffling your hand into your library, drawing that many cards, and creating that many flying insects with haste. Hey, throw in the added spice of Expansion Explosion and choose Explosion to deal X damage to any target, and target player draws X cards, which is you, creating a swarm of insects all over again. Speaking of swarms, let's look at the Golgari Swarm. Hearthstone and Slimefoot the Stowaway. Slimefoot the Stowaway likes to make sapperlings for 4 colorless mana. Slimefoot also likes sapperlings to die, so your opponents each lose 1 life, and you gain 1 life. Phyrexian Altar helps satisfy Slimefoot both ways. Spend 4 mana to make a sapperling, sacrifice the sapperling to give you a mana, and then use it and 3 other mana to activate Slimefoot again. With Hearthstone, you can chain the effect for even less mana. For added Golgari spice, add Fecundity, which lets any player draw a card whenever a creature they control dies. Speaking of creatures dying, next up is Gruul. We want to combo Altar with Deathrender and Hoarding Dragon. You see, when a creature equipped with Death Render dies, you get to put a creature from your hand onto the battlefield with Death Render equipped to it. Help it die on command with Phyrexian Altar. When Hoarding Dragon enters the battlefield, you search your library for an artifact and exile it. And when Hoarding Dragon dies, you can put the artifact in your hand. If you don't already have Phyrexian Altar and Death Render, the dragon will help you pull together the combo. For added spice, Vicious Shadows is an enchantment that triggers each time a creature dies, dealing damage to an opponent equal to the number of cards in their hand. If your opponents have been holding on to too many cards, sacrificing creatures to Phyrexian Altar can dish out a ton of damage. The Azurius Senate approves the combining of False Prophet with Nim Deathmantle. You see, people try to do all kinds of crazy shenanigans with creatures in Commander, and it's often up to an Azurius player to put a stop to it. False Prophet exiles all creatures when it dies, which cleans up a cluttered battlefield and stops graveyard recursion shenanigans. Phyrexian Altar lets you sacrifice False Prophet on demand. The altar also sacrifices any of your own creatures for mana before sacrificing False Prophet so your creatures aren't exiled. Leave it to the Azurius Senate to find a loophole. Nim Deathmantle triggers when one of your creatures dies, and for 4 mana you can bring the creature back from the graveyard equipped to Nim Deathmantle. Use the mana from the altar to bring False Prophet right back and keep laying down the law. For added spice, sacrifice Yosei, the Morning Star, which has a dies trigger that takes away a player's next untapped step and lets you tap 5 permanents they control. We must have order. Or perhaps not, because up next is the Cult of Rakdos, where we're combining Open the Graves with Blood-Soaked Champion. Open the Graves gives you a 2/2 zombie token when one of your creatures dies, which is nice when you're sacrificing creatures to Phyrexian Altar. But Blood-Soaked Champion makes a fine creature to sacrifice due to its raid ability, where for 1 and a black, return Blood-Soaked Champion from your graveyard to the battlefield. Activate this ability only if you attacked with a creature this turn. You can spend mana from the altar to pay the champion again and again and again to make, well, a whole bunch of 2/2 zombies. And for added spice, play Black Market, which gets a charge counter each time a creature dies. At the beginning of your main phase, you get a black mana for each charge counter. Who knew demonic cultists were such financial geniuses? But I'm hungry for some more combo splicing with the Simic Combine, combining Hungry Lynx with Arcane Adaptation. Hungry Lynx is a cat. It doesn't like rats. It has protection from rats. And whenever a rat dies, all your cats get a +1/+1 counter. Leave it to the Simic to ask the question, what if your cats are also rats? When the Arcane Adaptation enters the battlefield, you can choose rat, and then all your creatures are also rats in addition to their other types. Now, whenever one of your cat rats die, your other cat rats gets a +1/+1 counter. Ingenious. Of course, sometimes your opponents won't cooperate in killing your cat rats, and that's where Phyrexian Altar comes in, giving you a mana and letting you get the Hungry Lynx trigger whenever is optimal. For added spice, Faces of the Past is an enchantment that says whenever a creature dies, untap all tapped creatures that share a creature type with it. So you can then untap your cat rats whenever one of them dies. And these, of course, are just 10 potential combos with the almighty Phyrexian Altar, now reprinted at rare in Ultimate Masters. Take that, secondary market. I hope. I hope very much this video has been of some help to you. You can help me out by remembering to watch my previous video, which is a review of Magic the Gathering books, because YouTube tanked it. So please help me out by watching it, because no one was notified and no one watched it, and it was a lot of hard work. Thanks! And this video is brought to you by my and many other people's local game store, Card Kingdom, a brick and mortar pillar of this community, as well as the Patreon support of viewers such as you. These are the people that keep Tolarian Community College going and growing strong. So thank you.